Hey guys, welcome back to FTD Speaks. This is Leroy Kenton here. Now, I've noticed that you guys have been really enjoying the Amadidat videos that I've been reacting to, and I came across another one. It's about why the Pope walked out on him. So is like, which Pope is he referring to? And what was the circumstances around the Pope walking out? Was it a physical walkout or what? Well, so I got questions, of course. My brain is going, and I'm sure you got questions too if you haven't seen the video. So let's watch it together right now, and then let's talk about it at the end.
His Holiness the Pope is busy. And he is the head of 850 million Roman Catholics.
Yeah.
His Holiness the Pope. And His Holiness the Pope has just made a proclamation. You get this Morning Star and you read there, he is making his wish known to the world that he wants to have a dialogue with the Muslims. Dialogue. You know what's a dialogue? A friendly chat, an exchange of views, communication between one group of people and another, in this particular instance, with the Muslims. This is what Allah Bari Ta'ala is telling us in the Holy Quran. In the ayah I read to you from Surah Ali Imran, if you wanted to know where Imran is in the Quran, you don't start paging through 2,000 pages to find where Imran is. What you do, go to the index and look for the word Imran under I, and it'll tell you chapter 3. And 3 is easy to find because every page is numbered. Once you have found chapter 3, I'm now telling you ayah number 64. 64 is easy to find because every verse is numbered. Once you have found it, read it. Allah says, "Qul, tell them, Ya Ahl al-Kitab." So, oh people of the book, oh people of the book. Who are the people of the book? Our learned men will tell us unanimously that these are the Jews and the Christians.
Christians are the people of the book.
Jews and Christians. Allah Bari Ta'ala is telling us to call them, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, ta'alaw. Ta'alaw. Come. Ila kalimatin sawa'im baynana wa baynakum. That we come to common terms as between us and you. Let us get onto a common platform. Let us get together for the sake of mankind, for the sake of peace, for the sake of God. Let us get together on a common platform. And the basis of getting together, Allah gives us the conditions. I want somebody to tell me they are unreasonable. I want to find people to tell me that these are unreasonable conditions. Number one, Allah says, Allah na'budu illallah, that we worship none but Allah. Wala nushrika bihi shay'an, and that we associate no partners with him. Wala yattakhiza ba'duna ba'dan arbaban min dunillah, and that we do not take from among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. Fa in tawallaw fa qulu ashhadu bi anna muslimun, but if they turn back, tell them that we are Muslims, meaning that we have submitted our wills to the will of Allah. Whatever Allah wants us to do, we are prepared to do. But let us get together in the fellowship of faith, in the worship of the one true God. There's only one God, and let us worship him, whom we Muslims call Allah. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not our Allah. Inform the people. Let them know. But there are millions of people who don't know these things. They think that we Muslims are the Antichrist, the Dajjals, the enemies of Jesus. They do not know that in this Holy Quran are enshrined the virtues of Maryam alayhi salam, the mother of Jesus. And this mighty messenger of God, Jesus, his birth is described in two places in the Holy Quran. They don't know that we Muslims, we believe that Jesus was one of the mightiest messengers of God. That we believe in his miraculous birth. That we believe that he was the Masih, the Messiah, translated Christ. And we believe in his many miracles, including those of giving life to the dead by God's permission, and of healing those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. In my country, when I tell this to my fellow countrymen, the Christians, they are thinking that I'm trying to curry favor with them, trying to be nice to them, that if I scratch their back, they might scratch my back. If I can say a few good words about their Jesus, they in turn might say a few good words about our Nabi Kareem, Muhammad. You know, That's far from the truth. The Holy Quran in this has enshrined what I'm telling you about. There is a chapter in the Quran called Surah Maryam, in honor of the name of the mother of Jesus Christ. Surah Maryam. It happens that in the Christian Bible, there is no such book. This Christian Bible I have in my hand, the Old and the New Testament put together, this particular one of the Roman Catholics, I'm sorry, this one of the Protestant world has 66 books inside. 66. Mm-hmm.
66
the Roman
books.
Catholic version has 73 books inside. 73 booklets put together creates the encyclopedia called the Bible. In those 73 books of the Roman Catholics and 66 of the Protestants, there is not a single book entitled Mary. You open the Quran and you find chapter Mary, Surah Maryam. Now you have to inform this to people. His Holiness the Pope, he wants to have a dialogue. Wherever he goes, he wants to have a dialogue with the Muslims. But suppose His Holiness was here today with us. I would have, in all humility, approached him. Your Holiness, the Quran tells us to have a dialogue with you. Ta'alaw, ta'alaw. Allah tells us to call them ta'alaw, ta'alaw. And in the book of Isaiah, also the Holy Bible tells you, come, let us reason together. Come, let us reason together. So, we are going to have a little dialogue. Though I had tried to have a dialogue with him, I had written to him, but unfortunately it didn't come about. But hypothetically, this evening, let us say that His Holiness is here with us today, and we want to have a dialogue with him, and we start. I start by asking His Holiness, Your Holiness, what does the Bible, your Holy Bible says about Muhammad? What do you expect to hear from him? Or any learned man of Christianity? The priests, parsons, predicants, ministers, bishops, archbishops.
About
without
Muhammad.
Hesitation, they will tell us nothing.
Mm-hmm.
If you ask any Christian, what does the Bible, your Bible, say about Muhammad? They will tell you nothing. You may ask, why nothing? Does not the Holy Bible speak about the rise of Israel, the rise of communism, and even the beast? In the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, it speaks about a beast, and it even speaks about Gog and Magog. Yajuj, Majuj. All these things are mentioned in the Bible. They will say yes, they are. Then surely it must have something to say about this mighty messenger of God, Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who made it possible for 1 billion Muslims today, 1 billion, 1,000 million Muslims in the world, to believe in Jesus. Because no Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus. This man, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who made that possible, surely there must be something about him in the Bible. The man will tell you, it's his son, my son. If there was anything, I would have known it. I would have seen it. I would have recognized it. But this word Muhammad is not to be found anywhere in the Bible. You may, if you have my book, it is being given out, what the Bible says about Muhammad. There is a reference there that in the Hebrew Bible, in the original Hebrew language, in the Song of Solomon, chapter 16, verse 5, it says, Hikko mamittakim vi kullo Muhammadim zahdudi vi zahre'i baina Jerusalem. The word there is Muhammadim, which is Muhammad, with respect and honor. In the Hebrew language, there are two types of plurals, plural of respect and plural of numbers. This is a plural of respect. As we read the Quran, as Allah says, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafizun. That it is for us to send down the revelation and it is for us to protect it. Who is this us? Father, Son and Holy Ghost? No, we don't believe in that. Who? Allah, Jibreel and Muhammad? Astaghfirullah. No. Who is this we? Who is this us? We know that in the Arabic language, this is a plural of respect. Allah is talking about Himself like the royal we, the royal plural. So Muhammadim, Muhammad is mentioned by name. But the Christian world, in the translations, they have translated the word Muhammadim into the word altogether lovely. So when you read the English Bible, it says altogether lovely. You can't imagine that they're talking about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like, for example, if it was the praised one, Muhammad means the praised one. If it was written the praised one, you won't think, you can't imagine this talking about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we said, now let us reason, let us reason. There are chapters and verses in the Holy Bible where our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is referred to.
All right, guys. So first thing I want to mention is that, no, the Pope didn't walk out on Ahmed Didat, as the title of the video said. From what Ahmed Didat was saying is that the Pope was a very busy person. He is looking to have dialogue, or the Pope at the time was looking to have a dialogue with Muslims everywhere he goes and everything. And he wasn't able to be or able to meet with Ahmed Didat, but it doesn't say walked out on. It's just of whatever circumstances. He doesn't elaborate. He just says, you know, it just wasn't able to be done. But either way, Ahmed Didat is open for, or was open for, a discussion, and there are some things that he wanted to highlight and share about Islam to the Christian world. And we know it, that many Christians, they don't know what Islam says about Jesus, what Islam says about Mary. I know even growing up, I was very familiar with the Bible, and I learned much, much later that there was a surah, Maryam. And I remember having a dialogue some years ago with a Muslim fellow, and says that, oh yeah, we believe in Jesus too. And exactly the same thing that Ahmed Didat said. I'm like, okay, maybe he's just trying to say something nice to, like, you know, get on my good side so that maybe I can be more open to hearing what he says. But little did I know that the Quran has a lot to say about Jesus, although some of the details are a little bit different from what the Bible says. But, you know, on a whole, Muslims believe in Jesus. So it was surprising to me. And this is, again, why it's so important to, yeah, have these dialogues, have these discussions, because people a lot of times simply just don't know. And in ignorance, people speak, because, you know, in my ignorance, I didn't know. So I said, oh, Muslims, they don't believe in Jesus. All I'm hearing is Muhammad, 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 Muhammad. And I've never read the Quran, never heard any Muslim talk about Jesus, just Muhammad, Muhammad, Muhammad. So in my ignorance, I didn't know. And I just said, okay, well, they don't believe in Jesus. But that wasn't the case. Next thing, though, I want to point out, though, is near the end, in the book Song of Solomon that Ahmed Didat was talking about, that says that there's a word Muhammadim in it, and it's like a plural to show respect. Now, I've seen this being discussed from multiple angles before, that name is, it's a proper name in the original Hebrew language. Others argue and say that, no, it's actually not a proper name. It's translated as the one who is praised, or altogether lovely, however the various translations or the wording goes, but it's not a proper name. So I've heard both arguments, and both heard valid good points from either side. One thing I'm not quite sure about, though, is Songs of Solomon is one of those books that for non-Christians and non-Jews, they say that that book is filth, because it's very graphic and explicit when it speaks about the female body and things of a sexual nature. And it's like, it's seen as filth in the Bible. Like, how could that be in there? You know, but I've heard it being argued that it's mentioning the name Muhammad, and it's talking about Muhammad, and it's prophesied about Muhammad and everything. So it's like, what is it? Is it filth, or is it just more than that? And if you've ever read the book Song of Solomon, which I have, you'll see that some parts of it, it's like a dialogue from a woman and a man. And some of the things is, it's almost like a dialogue, a love letter in a sense. This is something that, you know, I've just been a little unsure about. Like, what's the Muslim stance on this? Like, Songs of Solomon, Is it regarded as just filth? I know it's been described as porn in the Bible, but it's still believed that Muhammad by name is mentioned in the book. So Muhammad's name is in the book, Songs of Solomon, and it's relating to the prophecy of him. What is it? Is it filth or is it prophecy and talking about Muhammad? That's all I gotta say in this one, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you watch this video until the end and you enjoyed the discussion. And let's continue it below in the comment section. Let me know your thoughts. Leave a like if you like this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.